in question number one, interior type. When the disc is rotated through angle theta, the extension of spring becomes d theta. And the vibrational energy of the system becomes 1 by 2 k d eta square, which is in fact initially is in the form of potential energy. When we release the system, system will maintain this vibrational energy. When this disc is in equilibrium position, this amount of energy gets converted to kinetic energy, which is our requirement. So when you substitute the numerical values of k, d and theta, you get the answer, required answer. Yes, sir. In interior question number two, there's a dumbbell that has been spun on a rough surface. This is direction of instantaneous velocity. That means at this instant, the frictional force will be acting tangentially. And similarly, on this dumb particle, this is the frictional force. These frictional forces produce a net torque that will be net force into moment arm, which is I alpha. This equation gives to you value of angular acceleration. And as we have been told, that final angular velocity is zero. That means, from the equation, the time taken will be given by omega naught upon alpha, which can be calculated from the first equation. On substituting numerical values, you will get your answer. Yes, sir. In question number 3, first we will have to solve the, what is the acceleration of 5 kg and 3 kg blocks. Then we will solve the, what is acceleration of 2 kg block. So first of all, I am writing equations for accelerations. So for 5 kg block, 5g minus t is equal to, for the trolley, the friction force acts opposite to its motion. The equation for the trolley is tension t minus friction force, which is 20 mu k equal to 3 a1. From here we get 5g minus 20 mu k equal to 8 a1. Next we solve for the acceleration of 2 kg block. For 2 kg block, friction acts in this direction. So acceleration of the 2 kg block will be given by this equation. Since it is given that block falls off from the cart in 0.8 seconds after traveling distance of 40 cm. That means 40 cm is equal to 1 by 2 a relative t square. So when you substitute the expression for a1 and a2 in our far expression, you get the value of mu k from this equation. In question number 4, if you choose x, y, z axis according to this diagram, the magnetic field applied is along x axis. That means the motion of the particle will be along a helix. This x component of motion will be unaffected due to the reversal of x-matic field. Then during the entire motion, particle's x displacement continues with this velocity. Y component is responsible for netmatic force, which is responsible for circular motion. The circular motion will take place in the YZ plane, which has been represented in the diagram. During the time interval, 5 t naught by 4. So during time interval, delta t equal to 5 t naught by 4. It's equivalent to one complete revolution and one quarter of a revolution. After one complete revolution, particle comes back to the x-axis. And then during another quarter of revolution, it reaches at this point. That means net displacement has a x component and the component root 2r. Then overall displacement will be vector sum of x displacement and displacement in yz plane. Overall displacement becomes x component velocity into time interval and displacement in YZ plane, where time period will be given by 2 pi m upon bq and radius will be given by m vy upon bq. After calculation of time period and radius, you can calculate net displacement in the given time interval. We have to calculate matic flux through this plane. As we can see, the matic field of wire inside it is non-uniform and it is given by this expression. It depends on the radial distance. So we have to integrate to obtain the result. We choose a strip at distance x of thickness dx. Matic field at the position of this strip is mu naught Ix upon 2 pi r square. If we take L length of this strip, then flux through this L length is this. Overall, the flux length is integral of this function from 0 to r, which is our answer. Yes, sir.